time to experience something glorious. Unacademy Combat. Compete, crack, conquer.
A challenging GATE contest engineered to give you an experience like none other.
Where you put your knowledge to test.
And battle it out with the best.
To bring out the best in you, Unacademy Combat is the most competitive gamified contest for GATE till date. With the best of the questions by best educators.
With detailed video solutions from top educators right after each contest.
Combat live with peers to get real-time rankings and win big.
Participate in every contest to improve your ratings.
Challenging contests every fortnight or alternate Sunday. Live ranking after every question. Big rewards for top rankers. Your passion to crack GATE deserves this. Your hard work towards your dream deserves this. Fuel your inner fire for the ultimate GATE challenge. Unacademy Combat. Register now.
Hello, good evening everyone. Hope you all are well. I am also well now. Recovered from COVID-19 in the past 2 to 3 weeks. The situation was horrible for me and my family. That's why I couldn't take the classes. And now I am feeling better and my family as well. So from today onwards, we are going to continue our remaining topics in this particular subject, industrial instrumentation. That is a transducer for GATE, VSU and HPCL. So welcome back everyone and welcome myself also. My name is Rajat Kumar Jain. I have qualified GATE with AIR 212 in the year 2012. Beside that, I have qualified BARC test, IBBS test, SSC test, pursuing PhD and having 11 plus years of teaching experience and mentored thousands of students to achieve success in GATE. And I have taken 6 to 7 different subjects for GATE and PSUs and other examinations. So guys, aap mera code use kar sakte hain RAJAT11 to get plus subscription. Aur plus subscription lekar aapko kya benefits milenge? Let us talk about that. Why you should take plus subscription? Aapko plus subscription kyun lena chahiye? Because the benefit of live classes, crash courses, weekly test, doubt solving sessions and the classes are both in English and Hindi. That is a really good advantage, right? The iConnect subscription covers all the benefits of plus subscription as well as some additional benefits of iConnect subscription. What are the additional benefits? Personal coach, ek one-on-one coach aapko assign kiya jayega, who will take care of your study, study planner, study booster sessions, Personalized test analysis. This is really beneficial for everyone who is having iconic subscription. Using this, you are going to find out कि आपका जो preparation है वो किस direction में जा रहा है, how you are attempting the questions. Then dedicated doubt clearing instructors, preparatory study material that can be used for lifelong. So these are the advantages of iconic subscriptions. So guys, wait ना करें और तुरंत subscription करें. Subscription करने के लिए आपको क्या करना है? You have to simply write an academy learning app. And in the Unacademy learning app, click on install right in your Google Play Store. Then after installation, register yourself by providing your email ID, by providing your name and your mobile number. After registration, go under the manage goal section where you have to select gate and EAC. That is our cup of tea right now, right? Uske baad plus pe click kare, phir गेट सब्सक्रिप्शन पे क्लिक करेंगे तो आपसे सब्सक्रिप्शन प्लान के बारे में पूछा जाएगा. नाउ द स्टूडेंट्स मे थिंक दैट वी शुड टेक वन मंथ प्लान, बट दैट इज एब्सोल्युटली रॉन्ग बिकॉज़ इट इज रियली रियली कॉस्टली. यू टेक 12 मंथ्स प्लान और 24 मंथ्स प्लान, इट इज वेरी वेरी चीप, राइट? एज द नंबर ऑफ मंथ्स इंक्रीजेस तो प्लान ऑटोमेटिकली क्या हो जाता है, सस्ता, राइट? सो यू कैन अप्लाई द डेमो कोड ओवर हियर. द डेमो कोड इज व्हाट, RAJAT11. क्लिक ऑन अप्लाई एंड प्रोसेस टू पेमेंट. पेमेंट समरी आपके सामने आ जाएगी और पेमेंट मेथड आपको पूछा जाएगा फॉर डूइंग द पेमेंट. सो एनी वन मेथड कैन बी सिलेक्टेड एंड अनअकैडमी इज द ओनली प्लेटफॉर्म, इंडियाज लार्जेस्ट लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म, ऑनलाइन लर्निंग प्लेटफॉर्म विच गिव यू द अपॉर्चुनिटी टू पे इन टर्म्स ऑफ EMI. सो दैट इज अ रियली गुड एडवांटेज, राइट? नाउ यू कैन टेक गेट एंड EAC सब्सक्रिप्शन in the two modes, right? Plus and iconic, as we discussed earlier. So plus subscription is available for 12 months, for 18 months and for 24 months, right? Now you can use my code RAJAT11, and after using my code, the subscription fee for the 12 month is 27,225, for 18 months is 34,650, and for 24 months is 39,600. Similarly, you can do iconic subscription by using my code RAJAT11, and it is available for 12 months and 24 months. It's not available for 18 months. So RAJAT11, after using my code, the fees is around 25,225 and 66,600 for 24. So guys, hurry and join these batches which are recently started from 28th of April, right? So in the last week, that means probably in this week itself, 28th of April, the new batch for GATE 2022 for electrical engineering, right? So you can learn from top educators of the country, right? Top educators in the sense they have experience of cracking the GATE 1 rank or IAS qualified faculties, right? IIDM faculties. So it's a really good, huge advantage for you for electrical engineering, right? For GATE 2022, similarly for GATE 2023, Ascent batch with the same pool of faculty, right? Use my code RAJAT11 to get enrolled into it. And then electronics and communication also for that Evolve batch for our GATE 2022. That is started from 28th of April. You can join this batch because it is not so much far away, 28th of April. And Ascent batch for GATE 2023. So guys, do hurry and use my code RAJAT11 to subscribe for plus subscription. So follow me on Unacademy at https://unacademy.com, at rajatkjain170 as you were doing earlier also. And you can join this Telegram channel. Spread this Telegram channel information or link among your friends so that they can also get this advantage of having lecture notes and videos and all the job related updates and all those things, right? So guys, in today's lecture we are going to discuss about vacuum measurement methods, because while we discuss the pressure measurement methods, due to some technical flaw the vacuum measurement method couldn't be completed at that time. So now it is the time to discuss this particular thing. In the previous lecture, however, on 7th of April, I took the last lecture as I remember, right? On that 7th of April lecture, we have discussed about the important problems on flow meters, some of the important problems on differential pressure flow meters, ultrasound flow meters. We have discussed those problems. Now you can refer that lecture. The lecture heading was itself the important problems on flow meters. So now in the previous 23 lectures, rather this is lecture number 24 of this particular series. So तो प्रीवियस 23 लेक्चर्स में हमने बहुत सारा मैकेनिकल मेजरमेंट, आप जिसे कह सकते हो, या इंडस्ट्रियल इंस्ट्रूमेंटेशन की बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट इंपॉर्टेंट टॉपिक्स हमने क्या किए हैं, कवर किए हैं, और उसको उस प्रोस्पेक्टिव से कवर किया है कि दैट विल बी हेल्पफुल फॉर यू इन द गेट एज वेल एज इन द PSU examination. Okay guys, तो आपको कोई भी प्रॉब्लम है, अगर still if you are having any doubts, so we are having the doubt session also. हम next week में एक doubt session भी रखेंगे, जिसमें आप आपके doubts के साथ में आ सकते हैं, whatever doubt you are having regarding this particular subject. Okay? So in today's lecture we are going to cover, right? क्योंकि अब बहुत दिनों बाद आज lecture ले रहा हूँ, तो आज का lecture हम इन topics के साथ में conclude करेंगे, और आज के ये जो topics हैं सारे, these are all our theoretical topics. इससे पीएसयू में क्वेश्चन तो जरूर आते हैं, गेट में क्वेश्चंस कम पूछे जाते हैं, एंड गेट में एक ही टॉपिक है जो हॉट फेवरेट टॉपिक है, दैट इज पिरानी गेज, तो हम उसके बारे में डिस्कशन करेंगे. और पीएसयूज में इससे क्वेश्चंस इसलिए ज्यादा पूछे जाते हैं क्योंकि ये थ्योरेटिकली ये टॉपिक बहुत बहुत ईजी माना जाता है फॉर क्रिएटिंग द क्वेश्चंस, दीज टॉपिक्स, राइट? तो हम डिस्कस करते हैं एक एक करके प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम्स के बारे में, राइट? वैक्यूम मेजरमेंट मेथड्स, मैक्लॉड गेज, पिरानी गेज, थर्मोकपल गेज, आयोनाइजेशन गेज और न्यूटसन गेज, आज हम इसके बारे में डिस्कशन करेंगे. प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम से यहाँ पे मेरा मतलब क्या है दोस्तों, राइट? एम आई ऑडिबल क्लियरली टू एवरीवन? प्लीज रिप्लाई इन द चैट बॉक्स सो दैट द थिंग्स कैन बी करेक्टेड. प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम्स में स्कीम से मतलब है दोस्तों कि हम किस तरह का प्रेशर मेजर करने वाले. सो दीज स्कीम्स कैन बी क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री टाइप्स, राइट? ओ थैंक यू वेरी मच फॉर रिप्लाइंग. ये जो प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम्स हैं, दीज आर क्लासिफाइड इनटू थ्री टाइप्स, राइट? व्हाट आर दीज थ्री टाइप्स? द मीडियम प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम्स, जिसके बारे में हम ऑलरेडी डिस्कस कर चुके, राइट? मीडियम प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम, लो प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम जिसको हम वैक्यूम भी कह रहे हैं, और हाई प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम. तीन भागों में इनको डिवाइड किया गया, तीन पार्ट्स में इसको डिवाइड किया गया. तो ऑलरेडी हमने मीडियम प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम डिस्कस की है, दैट इज द मैनोमीटर्स एंड द प्राइमरी सेंसर्स, राइट? बर्डन ट्यूब, बेलोज एंड डायफ्राम्स, ये चीजें हम डिस्कस कर चुके हैं. दीज वी हैव ऑलरेडी डिस्कस्ड, राइट? वी हैव डिस्कस्ड दीज थिंग्स. And this portion was remaining, low vacuum measurement techniques and high pressure measurement scheme. So today we are trying to cover all these methods. Okay, let's discuss one by one these methods. MacLeod gauge. सबसे पहला और सबसे important gauge कहलाता है MacLeod gauge. MacLeod gauge की सबसे बड़ी खासियत ये है दोस्तों कि the measurement is independent of gas composition. सबसे जो important चीज है इसकी वो ये है, the measurement is independent of gas composition. Gas composition. That is the really, really, really very, very important thing, very, very advantageous thing regarding the MacLeod gauge. So as the name suggests, Officer Sir MacLeod designed this gauge, or is gauge ka use pressure वैक्यूम मेजरिंग डिवाइसेस को कैलिब्रेट करने के लिए ज्यादा किया जाता है. इट्स अ लैबोरेटरी काइंड ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट. ये कैसा इंस्ट्रूमेंट है? इट इज अ लैबोरेटरी काइंड ऑफ इंस्ट्रूमेंट व्हिच इज यूज्ड फॉर कैलिब्रेटिंग अदर प्रेशर, अदर वैक्यूम गेजेस. जस्ट रिमेंबर, कैलिब्रेटिंग अदर वैक्यूम गेजेस, इट इज यूज्ड फॉर दैट पर्पस. नाउ व्हाट इज द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वर्किंग? द प्रिंसिपल ऑफ वर्किंग इज वेरी सिंपल. व्हाट इज दैट? आप लो प्रेशर को हाई प्रेशर में कन्वर्ट कीजिए, और हाई प्रेशर को कैपिलरी डिस्प्लेसमेंट के थ्रू मेजर कीजिए. दैट इज व्हाट पॉइंट सिमिलर टू द यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर. व्हाट इन वी डू इन यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर, द सेम थिंग. हम यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर में भी यही करते हैं कि क्या करते हैं हम यूट्यूब मैनोमीटर में? वन लेग इज एक्सपोज्ड टू द प्रेशर कंडीशन, वन लेग इज एक्सपोज्ड टू द एटमॉस्फेयर, एंड द प्रेशर कंडीशन ट्राई टू चेंज द mercury in that particular leg. The displacement of mercury in that particular leg is measured in terms of height, और हाइट मेजर करके हम क्या करते हैं, प्रेशर को मेजर करते हैं. तो द सेम थिंग इज डन इन द मैक्लॉड गेज ऑल्सो. सो हाउ इट वर्क्स, लेट्स टॉक अबाउट द मैक्लॉड गेज वर्किंग. सी हियर गाइस द टू फिगर्स, फिगर ए एंड फिगर बी केयरफुली. लेट मी जूम इट फॉर वंस. Right, this figures we are talking about, and with this figures we will understand the working of MacLeod. So in the figure A and figure B, see what is happening, what is done. First of all, dear Mahesh, okay, I will try to cover something in English and something in Hindi because both the students are present over here. So let's discuss this in both the languages for your sake, okay, no problem in that. So the MacLeod gauge, how it works, let's see this, how it works. See the figure A. The vacuum source is given from this particular capillary, okay, and there is a piston, there is a reservoir, we can say this is called as a reservoir. The reservoir holds mercury in quite some amount, mercury, right? And before connecting this vacuum source to the pressure, before connecting this this opening to the vacuum source, right, vacuum source, before connecting this opening to the vacuum source, the plunger is pulled up. Plunger means the piston, simply the piston is pulled up so that the mercury level in this particular volume bulb and the capillary bulb and the capillary falls below this particular level. This is the reference level where it is written as point A. So this piston is pulled up till this mercury level falls below this particular level, point A. जब तक mercury level इस point A से कम नहीं हो जाता, तब तक piston को ऊपर की तरफ खींचना पड़ेगा. That is what the working of this particular device. Now what will happen? Now you connect this pressure source. You will connect this pressure source, whatever with the unknown vacuum, right? It should be called as vacuum. Unknown vacuum source. You will connect over here. And the gas will trap inside this particular capillary, right? Because it is complete opening. This is complete opening, so gas cannot trap over here. यहाँ पर कोई गैस के trap होने की कोई जगह नहीं बचती है, right? Right? So the gas molecules will trap from this will trap in this large bulb. Now what you have to do? Now you have to push this plunger downward. आपको ये पिस्टन को क्या करना पड़ेगा? Downward push करना पड़ेगा. You have to push this plunger downward. So you can see this. Once we have connected this to the source, now we are pushing the plunger downward. Now how much we have to push? That is again very important because we have to do the measurement based on the reference. It is a method of converting the low pressure into high pressure. So how we are converting the low pressure into high pressure? So we are taking this reference of the reference capillary. So this is known as the reference capillary, that is capillary tube 2. This is known as the reference capillary, and this is known as the measuring capillary, capillary 1. Okay, so measuring capillary, capillary 1, reference capillary, capillary 2, and now we are pushing the piston downward. We are pushing the plunger downward. The plunger called, you can say it plunger or you can say it piston. So you are pushing it. So naturally, when you are pushing the plunger downward, the mercury will displace in the remaining space. No doubt about that. Right, the mercury will displace in the remaining space. Hence, good evening everyone, Vishal. Sir, so Siddharth is asking, sir, if source is vacuum, how can there are gas molecules in it? Vacuum means empty, na? Right. Siddharth, the vacuum means empty. That means the very less amount of gas molecule. Very, very less amount of gas molecules, right? The complete vacuum cannot be measured. It is an ideal situation. As you understand, it is an ideal situation, Siddharth. So your question is right, and everybody, they get confused regarding this. What we are talking about, vacuum. What do we mean by vacuum? Vacuum simply means that the pressure below the atmospheric levels. Right, now that atmospheric level pressure is what? That is 1 atm. Now what is 1 atm? 1 atm is around 1.033 torr. So what is that 1 atm value exactly if we assume? So we have to measure with the help of the barometer. That we have indeed discussed in the previous section or previous lecture of our pressure measurement schemes. So barometer, using the barometer, we are able to find out the atmospheric pressure. And if we compare the atmospheric pressure with this sort of vacuum, we will find that the atmospheric pressure value is very, very large. That means the amount of gas molecules present in the atmosphere are very, very large. And it is quite common for us, because if the gas is not present, oxygen is not present, the living things will not survive on the earth. The same thing, oxygen and other gases are present over the earth, they are contributing to the atmospheric pressure. Now if we go below to that pressure, anything below to the atmospheric pressure will be called as vacuum. And it is comprising some amount of gas molecules, not full gas molecules. We cannot say that it is completely gas. It is indeed called the gas molecule. Why? It is indeed called the vacuum, because the very less amount of gas molecules are present in that particular source. So vacuum means very, 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 very small amount of gas molecules. Because it is, if you remember the pressure definition. What is the pressure definition? Pressure means the molecules are bombarding onto the surface. They are exerting some force onto the surface. So which type of molecules? So in vacuum also we are saying that the number of gas molecules or number of air molecules are decreasing in the manner. That's why we are talking about that particular thing. Okay, Siddharth. So just be with this particular explanation whenever you are asked about. So there are some very, very small gas molecules will be present in the source to which we are connecting, to which we are measuring, right? And these gas molecules are going to be trapped inside this particular bulb. So as I said, we have to press this plunger, and when we are going to press this plunger, what will happen? The mercury will displace in the free space. It's no doubt about that. So how much we have to press this? Till the mercury reaches this particular point H2. जब तक मर्क्यूरी इस H2 पॉइंट तक रीच नहीं कर जाता, तब तक हमें इसे क्या करना पड़ेगा? प्लंजर को प्रेस करना पड़ेगा. ओके, नाउ वी विल चेक अबाउट दी स्पेस रिमेनिंग इन दिस पर्टिकुलर मेजरिंग कैपिलरी. सो यू कैन सी दैट द मर्क्यूरी इज द फर्दर डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ मर्क्यूरी इन द मेजरिंग कैपिलरी इज अपोज्ड. Further displacement of measuring capillary is opposed in this particular displacement of mercury in this measuring capillary is opposed by the amount of gas molecules trapped in this particular space. So, ये जो gas molecules trap हुए हैं, इसको हम measure कर सकते हैं, इस height को हम measure कर सकते हैं, और ये height हमें क्या देगी? Amount of vacuum. So, let us talk about the simple calculation, very very simple calculation in the next slide. Right? If final pressure, final volume and final pressure are given as Vf is equals to Ah, right? Vf is the final volume of gas which is trapped inside. A is the area of capillary and H is the height of mercury which has risen in the measuring capillary. So Pf is equals to Pv plus H, right? Pv is the initial volume of the gas. H is the height of the mercury which is caused due to this particular displacement that we have done. Then applying Boyle's law, very well known to us, very, very well known to everyone, right? The pressure and volume are directly proportional. So PFVF is equals to PVV, inversely proportional, sorry. So PFVF is equals to PVV. PF is final pressure into final volume is equals to initial pressure into initial volume. Now let us understand this. What is the meaning of final pressure? What is the meaning of initial pressure? Initial pressure means the vacuum which we have supplied from this. Final pressure means after the plunger has been pushed, what is the value of the pressure inside this particular capillary? That is what called final pressure. So initial pressure, what we have supplied, that must be equal to the final pressure as per the calculation, because the pressure energy is compressed. It is compressed, right? So it is going to remain the same. So Pf into Vf is equals to Pv into V. Pv is equals to, so from these two equations, we can conclude with that the vacuum pressure is given by Ah square upon V minus Ah. Now what is V over here? V is the volume of this bulb. A is the area of this capillary, right? And H is the height in this capillary up to which the mercury has risen. That is what the dimensional measurement of vacuum. That is what the biggest advantage of the McLeod gauge. अगर हम McLeod gauge को इस तरह से देखें, तो vacuum को हम dimensionally measure कर रहे हैं, which is very very difficult for the other type of gauges. Why? So because they are depending on the gas composition. में गैस के साथ में कुछ limitations होती है. यहाँ पे गैस कैसी भी हो, कैसा भी vacuum हो, it is independent of that because we are simply converting that gas pressure, that vacuum into displacement of mercury. So using this, we can say that our vacuum measurement is directly dependent on the value of H because this A is constant, this V is constant, and it is assumed normally that the value of V is much much higher than AH. That is why you can see that the approximated formula is this one. This is the approximated formula. And the first one is the exact formula. First one is the exact formula. Alright. So PV, that is the unknown vacuum, is equals to AH square upon V minus AH. And this can be approximated to AH square upon V by simply using the Boyle's law for the said condition. So guys, you can remember this particular formula. V is the volume of the bulb. This is the V. This is volume of the bulb in which the mercury is kept. This is V. Volume of the bulb. V is the volume of the bulb. Or volume of gas, we can say that, right? Volume of bulb, normally it is volume of gas, that is volume of bulb, okay? And PV, unknown pressure, A, area of capillary, and H, height of compressed gas volume in capillary, height of compressed gas volume in capillary. This is all given over here. Right, this, that means what is the capacity in which, if you understand this, what is the capacity in which, let me show you once again. What is the capacity in which this bulb can accommodate gases? Kitni capacity mein ye gas accommodate ho sakti hai? Here, that is what called volume. This is called as V. तो गाइज ये एक फॉर्मूला है, इंपॉर्टेंट फॉर्मूला है, जिसे आप याद रखेंगे तो बहुत अच्छी बात होगी. PV इज इक्वल टू AH स्क्वायर अपॉन V, एंड फ्रॉम हियर वी कैन से दैट द अननोन वैक्यूम प्रेशर इज डायरेक्टली अ फंक्शन ऑफ H. तो डायरेक्टली बाय कन्वर्टिंग द लो प्रेशर इनटू हाई प्रेशर और डिस्प्लेसमेंट ऑफ मर्क्यूरी वी कैन मेजर द वैक्यूम. Now let us talk about the next method, right? So the advantage, as I already told you, it is a laboratory kind of method used for calibrating other instruments. Its range is 10 to the power of minus 6 to 1 torr, and accuracy is as high as 1%, right? Very, very high accuracy. And the measurement is independent of gas composition. The measurement is done by converting the vacuum into the displacement of mercury. These are the advantages, all right? Now the thermodynamic principles. Let us talk about the next gauge. Very, very important gauge from the gate point of view, from the PSU point of view. A lot of time a question has been asked from this particular thermodynamic principle gauge, which is called as Pirani gauge. So based on this thermodynamic principle, we have to discuss the Pirani gauge working, and we have to understand the Pirani gauge working. The heat conductivity decreases with decreasing pressure. This is the fundamental statement that you can remember. Or you can understand, the heat conductivity decreases with decreasing pressure. Heat conductivity decreases with decreasing pressure. Alright, so what is the meaning of conductivity? What is the meaning of decreasing pressure? Decreasing pressure means decreasing gas molecules, right? What we will say that? Decreasing pressure means the decreasing gas molecules. So number of gas molecules, if they are decreasing, then the heat conductivity in the surrounding region will also decrease, because the gas molecules are having the ability to conduct the heat or carry away the heat, right? Normally, whenever you drink any hot thing, right? say you are drinking hot tea or hot coffee or hot milk, whatever you are drinking. Right, nowadays the people are used to drink the hot water as well because of the COVID situations, right? So hot water, hot coffee, hot milk, hot drink, whatever you are drinking, you try to use your mouth's air to cool it down. Why? So because the mouth air molecules are able to carry away that heat. So that is what the concept of thermodynamic principles which are applied over here, that the gas molecules are having the tendency to carry away the heat. Normally we have seen this, right? So based on this particular statement, three conclusions have been drawn. What are these conclusions? If you study, if you read over here, then you will find out this. So what are these three conclusions? If heat dissipation or voltage of a wire is kept constant, then temperature varies with current. One of the conclusion is that. Second, maintaining constant resistance or temperature and noting the changes in energy output as a function of pressure. This can also be done. And the third one, maintaining constant current and observing changes in filament resistance as a function of pressure. This is the third one which is used in the Brani gauge. This third one is used in the Brani gauge because it is the simplest method by which we can measure the vacuum or the low pressure. Okay, so how it is done? Let us talk about Pirani gauge. Alright, so Pirani gauge is what? The Pirani gauge is going to measure the vacuum. And it is comprising a glass tube. This is a glass tube. Inside the glass tube, a heater element, that is a metal wire, we can say that. Right, metal wire. Which is heated. Metal wire which is heated. Alright. And heated means that is supplied from the bridge supply itself. No other supply is there. It is heated from that bridge supply. And to compensate for this resistance, we are using three other resistance of the same value. Naturally, because it is a metal wire, it will be having some self-resistance. So its resistance will be compensated by some other resistance and forming a Wheatstone bridge. The most obvious choice for a resistance variation. No doubt about that. We have discussed quite a lot about the Wheatstone bridge technique. So in the Wheatstone bridge is used here also for detecting the unknown vacuum. So what we are supposed to do? We are going to connect the vacuum source over here. Right? Vacuum source over here. Now, if the vacuum increases, see here, the vacuum increases. Now you will understand what is the difference between vacuum and why I was calling in earlier also the gas molecules, right? So if vacuum increases, that means the gas molecule decreases, as obvious we know that. So gas molecules, if they are decreasing, then the heat of this wire is going to be trapped inside. Yahi pe kya ho jayegi? Ye heat trap ho jayegi. Aur ye heat jab trap ho jayegi, तो ये हीट सराउंडिंग का टेम्परेचर बढ़ा देगी. सराउंडिंग का टेम्परेचर अगर बढ़ाएगी, सराउंडिंग इफ द सराउंडिंग टेम्परेचर इंक्रीजेस, सिंस इट इज अ मेटल वायर, देन इट्स ऑन रेजिस्टेंस चेंजेस, इट्स ऑन रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस. सिंस इट इज अ मेटल वायर, ड्यू टू इंक्रीज इन हीट, इट्स ऑन रेजिस्टेंस इंक्रीजेस. दिस चेंज इन रेजिस्टेंस इज गोइंग टू कॉज द चेंज इन करंट, एंड दिस चेंज इन करंट इज प्रोपोर्शनल टू अमाउंट ऑफ vacuum. Larger the vacuum, larger is the change in resistance. Smaller the vacuum, smaller is the change in resistance, because if smaller is the vacuum, by smaller vacuum we say that the pressure is increasing. Just remember, just try to understand this thing, which are contradictory in nature but having the similar meaning, right? Pressure is higher, that means the vacuum is smaller. Vacuum is smaller, that means the pressure is higher. And vacuum is higher, that means the pressure is smaller. So vacuum high means the less number of gas molecules are present over there, right? So the gas molecules, if they are not present in this particular surrounding, they are not going to carry away the heat. That's why we have written in the previous statement, the heat conductivity decreases with decreasing pressure. If the gas molecules are not present over there, then how they are going to carry away the heat? And the heat is going to be trapped inside this particular chamber because it is of glass. So glass doesn't conduct heat at all, right? So the heat is going to be trapped over here, and if it is going to be trapped, then the wire resistance is going to increase, or wire resistance to change due to that particular heat. That is what the fundamental principle behind Pirani gauge. Now, what type of question is asked? Which is the most likely question to be asked on Pirani gauge, as well as which is very, very, very favorite question of the question asking authorities? What is that? Pirani gauge works on the principle of that is the fundamental question which has been asked over the 1000 times in most of the PSUs and other examinations, as well as GATE also. So Pirani gauge works on the principle of, simply you have to say the answer to this particular problem and this particular question is change in thermal conductivity of gases. Change in thermal conductivity of gases or principle of thermal conductivity, simply you can remember that. Principle of thermal conductivity, simply you can remember that. Okay guys, so let us move ahead with the advantages of Pirani gauge. Pirani gauge can measure the pressure or say vacuum in the range of 10 to the power minus 5 to 1 torr. Yeah, usually you remember for vacuum the unit torr is utilized. It is more rugged and more accurate, fast response to pressure changes and linear from this particular range. Disadvantage, it is expensive, right, initial cost, need frequent calibration for a different pressure. Requires frequent calibration for different pressure. These are the advantages and disadvantages of Pirani gauge. Now, one more gauge which is based on the same concept as the previous one, that is the thermocouple vacuum gauge. ये भी क्या है? Pirani gauge के concept पर ही based है. But अब यहाँ पर Wheatstone bridge use नहीं किया जाता. Wheatstone bridge is not used over here. Instead, we use thermocouple gauge. So what is done? If you see this diagram carefully, right? Let me zoom it. I will explain this thing. Okay. So here now we are having a chamber. This is the chamber we are having. And this particular opening is exposed to vacuum, and in the chamber we are having a metal wire, a heater element or a metal wire. This heater element is heated with the source, and a current meter or ammeter is placed so as to regulate the current through this particular source using this rheostat, and a thermocouple is attached to this particular heated wire. Right, thermocouple. What the thermocouple does? Everybody knows that, right? We know thermocouple. Thermocouple is a active temperature sensor. Okay. Let me switch on the power supply. Just a minute. So thermocouple is an active gauge, right, which is able to sense the temperature around its hot junction. So the thermocouple is going to measure this temperature, and it is going to indicate this temperature variation in the terms of voltage, right? That's the Seebeck effect, that is the Seebeck EMF that will be generated. So here we are using thermocouple instead of using the bridge concept. Bridge concept ko use karne ke bajaye hum yahan par kya use kar rahe hain? थर्मोकपल को यूज कर रहे हैं. तो थर्मोकपल क्या कर रहा है? व्हाट थर्मोकपल इज डूइंग? व्हाट इज द एक्शन ऑफ थर्मोकपल? लेट अस गो बैक टू द स्मॉल डायग्राम सो दैट यूजिंग द पेन आई कैन टेल यू. राइट, सो द थर्मोकपल इज मेजरिंग हीट ओवर हियर. मेजरिंग हीट, थर्मोकपल, व्हाट इट इज डूइंग? मेजरिंग हीट और टेम्परेचर. राइट, सिंपली थर्मोकपल इज मेजरिंग हीट और टेम्परेचर, एंड द थर्मोकपल is measuring heat or temperature that is proportional to amount of vacuum, because larger the vacuum, that means the amount of the gas molecules are decreasing over here. The gas molecules, if they are decreasing over here, the vacuum is larger. If the vacuum is larger, that means the heat is going to be trapped inside as before. Jaisa Pirani gauge mein ho raha tha, yahan par bhi wahi hoga. The heat will not be carried away by the gas molecules because the vacuum is very, very high. So the heat is going to be trapped. So the wire temperature is going to increase, and this increase in temperature can be measured with the help of the thermocouple, and the thermocouple reading then can be calibrated in terms of vacuum. Thermocouple ki reading ko hum kis mein calibrate kar sakte hain? Vacuum ke terms mein calibrate kar sakte hain. All right. So this is what called thermocouple vacuum gauge. which is quite similarly used, like the pirani cage. Only the difference is that here we are using the thermocouple instead of using the Wheatstone cage. The principle is almost same. So the range of such device is also from 10 to the power minus 4 to 1 torr, rugged and inexpensive, linear from 0.002 to 1 mm of Hg, convenient and continuous reading type of device. Disadvantage, process control is required, narrow reading range, right? Process control is required means the thermocouple cold junction compensation sometime may be required. Alright, next gauge is ionization gauge. So next gauge is ionization gauge. Guys, ionization gauge works on the concept of ionization of gases. So I suppose everybody is very much familiar with the word ionization. Ionization means simply picking up one electron from the neutral atom and making it more positive, right? That is called a positive ion or ionization. Or ionization, simply we can say that. So here ionization gauge works on the similar kind of principle of doing the ionization of gas molecules. So you can see here the diagram, I suppose, is clearly visible to everyone. This is a gas chamber, or the chamber in which we are going to apply the vacuum source. Okay. And this gas chamber is actually comprising three plates. One is the cathode, other one is the grid, and the third one is the plate. Simply, the plate is connected to a negative supply using this V2. The grid is connected to a positive supply, that is using this V1. The meter A is going to measure this current which is going to flow here, and meter B is going to measure this current which is going to flow over here. Okay. So let me clear it once again so that you will be able to see it. Now what will happen? See what happens and what is the meaning of ionization and how it is done. A high voltage here, high negative voltage is here given to the cathode. So what happens? Because of the amount of vacuum is present over here, low gas is present over here, the electron discharge starts. That is called as thermionic emission. Ye kya kehlata hai? Thermionic emission, right? So the electron starts discharging from it, from the cathode. Simply, we can say that the same effect is utilized in the cathode ray tube. So here also, when the cathode is heated and it is placed in a low pressure environment, it starts discharging the electrons. So some of these electrons will be collected by the grid. Why? So because the grid is having slightly more positive potential as compared to this one. This is a negative potential and this is a positive potential. So the electrons will be collected with the grid, and remaining electron are going to ionize the gas molecule which is present over here. The gas molecule which is present over here by bombarding it, by striking it, right? So the electron is going to ionize this particular gas molecule, and now the ionization will cause positive ion and electron. One positive ion and one electron. So that electron will be further collected by this particular grid, and that positive ion will be collected by this particular plate. So the plate current now will be dependent on the number of ions. Simply, they are measuring the density of the gas over present, gas molecules present. We can say that. Simply, we can say that it is dependent on the density of the gas molecules present over here. So larger is the density of the gas molecules, larger is the current IP, because more ionization is going to happen. If less number of gas molecules are present over here, then less ionization is going to take place. And if less ionization is going to take place, then the value of IP current will be less. So we can relate this vacuum with the value of IP and IG. You can see this relationship. The vacuum relationship is given by 1 by S IP by IG. 1 by S IP by IG. IP is plate current, IG is grid current, and S is the sensitivity of the gauge, which is the function of the grid voltages and the structure of the glass tube. So IP by IG. So larger is the vacuum, larger is the value of IP. Quite obvious, right? And smaller is the vacuum, smaller is the value of the IP. Okay, so that is what we can say, that the ionization gauge, how it works. Ionization gauge, sometimes it is also called as hot cathode ionization. Please remember, hot cathode ionization, इसे ये भी कहते हैं. Sometimes it is also called by, or it is also known by this particular terminology, hot cathode ionization, which is simply works on the principle of ionization of gases. Ionization gauge measures very, very low pressure, 10 to the power minus 3 to 10 to the power minus 11 torr. Very, very low pressure it measures, very fast response to pressure changes. Disadvantage is high cost and complex electrical circuit. Calibration varies with gases, right? It is dependent on the gas composition because the ionization process is dependent on gas composition. All right. Filament can burn out quickly if it is heated before pressure is at low value. So we have to take care about the filament burning also. Next and the last method to measure the vacuum is Knudsen gauge. Right. Knudsen or Knudsen gauge, whatever you to pronounce it, right? The better pronunciation is Knudsen gauge. The Knudsen gauge is based on the concept of the mean free path of electron. Simply, mean free path of electrons. Mean free path of electrons. It is based on the concept of this. Ultra low vacuum. It is also able to sense the ultra low vacuum. This Knudsen gauge. How it is going to measure the ultra low vacuum? Let us talk about this. Let us understand this working of the Knudsen gauge. See what happens. In the Knudsen gauge, this is the, see here the range is written over here, 10 to the power minus 8 to 10 to the power minus 3 torr. Very, very small vacuum can be measured, right? So, this is again a glass tube. The glass tube, the source is connected, vacuum over here, the source is connected and it is having two plates. One is the fixed plate and one is the movable plate. This is the movable plate or movable vane, and on the movable plate, one mirror is connected and the position of the mirror is balanced by the springs. And now using the light source, the light flash is falling onto the mirror. And the reflection is going to be measured in terms of scale of the vacuum. That is what it is done. So now how this reflection is going to take place? That is dependent on the amount of vacuum. That is dependent on amount of vacuum. So, kya hoga guys? See here. These plates are separated by very, very small distance. That is, that distance is around less than the mean free path of electron. So, let us see. It's another view of this particular arrangement. See here. These are the fixed plates. This are the fixed plates and the middle one is the movable plate. So they are very, very placed at a very small distance. Now what happens? And one more thing? These are the heated plates. That means temperature of these plates is higher than the temperature of this particular movable plate. Ye plate ka temperature, is plate ke temperature se zyada hota hai. So what will happen now, if the gas molecules are present over here, because of this higher energy or higher thermal energy of this heated plate, they will rebound quickly and go towards the cooler plate, thereby causing a force of deflection. And this force of deflection is going to deflect. This force of deflection is going to deflect this particular movable vane. Aur ye jo deflection hoga, ye deflection ki wajah se light source, since it is continuously following onto the mirror, the reflection of the mirror is going to be different onto the scale, which is the light scale. And it is not a very, very uncommon thing earlier. And it has been used over the years, the light scale. Say light scale kya. Okay. तो यहाँ पे आप क्या कर सकते हैं, मार्किंग कर सकते हैं और जहां जहां पे लाइट फॉल होगी अकॉर्डिंगली हम क्या कर सकते हैं, प्रेशर को मेजर कर सकते हैं. वी कैन मेजर द प्रेशर. सो दैट यू कैन रीड दिस. आई जस्ट maximize this once again, right? And you can understand now, the gap between the fixed plate and the movable vein must be less than mean free path of the gas molecules. Gas molecules rebound from the heated plates with a greater momentum than from the cooler movable vein. This gives a net force on the spring restricted movable vein. The force can be measured by the deflection of the movable vein. All right. Hello, Yagnik Mavni. The diagram is now clear. If you see here, once again you see here, I will explain this diagram, no problem in that, okay. So, this is the glass chamber. In this glass chamber, we are going to connect the vacuum source, right. This glass chamber is comprising two plates, and between them one plate is sandwiched. This one plate is movable. Its movement is controlled with the help of spring. This one plate is comprising a mirror, and mirror is allowed a light source, flash. Okay, so now if the movable plate moves, the mirror will also move. That the mirror will be reflect, changing its angle. So due to that, the light reflection is also going to change its angle. Okay, now why the mirror is going to move? Because the movable plate is going to move. Why movable plate is going to move? Because the number of gas molecules are taking energy from the heated plate, and they are rebounding this with a greater momentum. They are taking the energy, and now they are going to supply the energy, because the energy is converted always from one form to another form, right? So the energy is being captured by the gas molecules which are present in this particular surrounding, and now they are heading towards this movable vein. They are pushing this movable vein by some force, and that force is responsible for the movement of the movable vein by some amount of deflection, very very small in angle, right? It is not that it will be moving by 90 degree or so. It's a very very small angular displacement, angular deflection, very very small angular deflection. Okay, now it is clear to you, Yagnik? Now it is clear, this diagram is clear, or I can show you the another diagram also. The another diagram also, let me show you. Next one, from this also you can understand this. We are having this plate, this is the first plate. This is the first plate, these are heated plates. And the between these two plates, one movable plate is present over. This is the movable plate. This is the movable plate. This movable plate is comprising mirror. The light flash is always on. So due to movement of mirror, the reflection of the light will be different, which can be captured onto the scale. जिसे हम क्या कह सकते हैं? Light scale कह सकते हैं. We can say that the light scale. So this reflection of light onto this light scale will be directly proportional to vacuum. Will be directly proportional to vacuum. All right. So it is relatively insensitive to gas composition and thus gives promise of development into a standard for pressure too low for MacLeod gauge. ये वो pressure भी measure कर सकता है जो MacLeod gauge measure नहीं कर सकता. Okay. Pressure is determined by interaction of particles with a surface, its kinetic energy and is temperature dependent. When a particle hits a hotter surface, heat transfer will take place and the particle will gain energy. When a particle hits a colder surface, the opposite thing occurs. Particles that interact with a hotter or colder surface will exert a force on that particular surface. That's what I told you. A Knudsen manometer uses this temperature effect to make a plate with dual temperatures rotate, right? By reading the speed of this rotation, the pressure can be determined. इस तरह से क्या कर सकते हैं? Pressure को measure कर सकते हैं. So this is what called Knudsen gauge, which is able to measure very very low pressure. Next is high pressure measurement scheme. Before going for an end of the lecture, let us discuss about the high pressure measurement scheme also. This high pressure measurement scheme or high pressure measurement can be done with the help of Bridgman gauge and piezoelectric gauge used for high dynamic pressure. Bridgman gauge and piezoelectric gauge. So piezoelectric gauge, you know everything about piezoelectric crystal. There is nothing new in this piezoelectric crystal. So I am not going to cover that piezoelectric crystal section, because piezoelectric crystal is quite similar what we have discussed earlier, and you know everything, right? So Bridgman gauge, because Bridgman gauge we have not discussed earlier, so we are going to discuss about Bridgman gauge. It's a simple kind of pressure sensitive resistor, we can say. Pressure sensitive resistor. The Bridgman gauge works on this particular principle. Pressure sensitive resistor. So what is this pressure sensitive resistor? The thin wire of manganese. This is the pressure sensitive resistor. These are the screws for mounting the gauge. The pressure is being this is the kerosene filled bellows, right? That is the bellow, and the pressure is applied from this particular section, so it is going to contract the bellow. If the bellow is going to contract, the pressure is going to observe onto this particular thin manganese wire whose terminal is taken, so its resistance is going to change, and this resistance change is directly proportional to pressure. So how it is? How it is measured? Let us talk about that. By way of principle of operation, they make use of resistance. They make use of resistance change brought about by direct application of pressure to the conductor itself. Referring to the figure, the sensing element is a thin wire of manganese. Manganese is a combination of 84% of copper, 12% of manganese, and 4% of nickel, or an alloy of gold or chromium, which is loosely wound. When pressure is applied, bulk compression effects produce a change in resistance, which may be calibrated against pressure. And this pressure is given as, or this resistance is given as, R is equals to R naught 1 plus B delta P, which equation is quite similar to that equation, RT is equals to R naught 1 plus alpha delta T, right? This equation we have seen for so many times. But this equation probably you might not have seen, or you don't remember. If you don't remember, then you should remember now about the Bridgman gauge. At least you remember the name about the Bridgman gauge, right? Because most of the time the question have been asked from this particular section, that what is the Bridgman gauge? Why the Bridgman gauge is used? So Bridgman gauge is used for very, very high pressure measurement. Very, very high pressure measurement, because the high pressure can cause only the change in the resistance of this particular wire, which is placed inside this particular bellow, because a high pressure is going to deflect the bellow, and due to the deflection of bellow, the resistance of the wire, the bulk compression effect is going to change the resistance of the wire. So this equation is related in a similar manner to the temperature relationship. RT is equals to R naught 1 plus alpha delta T. Here also the relationship is given by R equals to R naught 1 plus B delta. The R naught is the resistance at ambient pressure. BB is the pressure coefficient of resistance. Delta B is gauge pressure, right? That is what the pressure we are going to sense. Used for pressure range of more than 70,000 megapascal. It's a huge range, right? 70,000 megapascal. Itni range ke liye aap kya kar sakte ho? Bridgman gauge ko use kar sakte. So guys, आज के लिए इतना ही. बड़े दिनों बाद मैं ये लेक्चर ले रहा हूँ, तो आज थोड़ा सा मुझे अच्छा फील हुआ आप लोगों के साथ फिर से एक बार इंटरैक्ट करके, और हम इस डिस्कशन को कंटिन्यू करेंगे कल भी. कल हम लेवल मेजरमेंट डिस्कस करेंगे. एट द सेम टाइम डू ज्वाइन अस, राइट? सो गाइस, बिफोर वी कंक्लूड, लेट मी टेल यू अबाउट अन अकेडमी कॉम्बैट क्विज कॉम्पिटिशन, जो की हर संडे आयोजित की जा रही है अन अकेडमी के द्वारा. Right, May 2, 9, 16, 23 and 30. The next combat goes live on May 2, that is tomorrow at 11 a.m. और इस वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में आपको इसकी लिंक मिल जाएगी, और आप इस क्विज को अनलॉक करने के लिए मेरा कोड यूज कर सकते हैं RAJAT11. आप मेरा कोड यूज कर सकते हैं RAJAT11 टू अनलॉक दिस पर्टिकुलर क्विज. और इस क्विज को क्वालिफाई करके आपको क्या बेनिफिट मिलेगा? पहला तो ये कि आप आपके वीक एरियाज को आइडेंटिफाई करके उन्हें इम्प्रूव कर सकते हैं, और आपकी प्रिपरेशन को असेस कर सकते हैं 60 मिनट्स में. और सेकंड चीज जो कि बहुत इंपॉर्टेंट है, कि अगर आपकी क्विज में रैंक 1-3 आती है, तो आपको कॉम्प्लीमेंट्री अनअकैडमी प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन मिलेगा फॉर एन ईयर. इफ योर रैंक इज 4-10, 75% ऑफ अनअकैडमी प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन फॉर द टेन्योर ऑफ योर चॉइस. The tenure can be 6 months, 12 months, or 18 months, or 24 months. और रैंक 11 टू 50 के लिए 50% ऑफ है प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन पर, रैंक 51 से 100 के लिए 25% ऑफ है प्लस सब्सक्रिप्शन। सो गाइस, इट्स अ रियली रियली ह्यूज एडवांटेज फॉर यू पीपल टू अप्लाई फॉर दिस अनअकैडमी कॉम्बैट क्विज, सो दैट यू कैन हैव दिस ऑप्टिमम बेनिफिट ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर स्कॉलरशिप, right? So if you have any rank between 1 to 100, you are going to get benefited from the point of view of scholarship onto the subscription. 25% is also a very very huge amount nowadays. Okay, so guys, aap mera code use kare RAJAT11, don't forget to use my code RAJAT11 if you are unlocking this particular quiz. If you are unlocking this quiz, then use my code RAJAT11. Kal subah 11 baje ye quiz kya hoga, live hoga, uske pehle aap abhi ke abhi क्या कर सकते हैं, इस वीडियो के डिस्क्रिप्शन में आपको लिंक मिलेगी जिससे आप क्या कर सकते हैं, रजिस्टर कर सकते हैं। ओके, तो थैंक यू वेरी मच गाइस, आज हमने डिस्कस किया है वैक्यूम मेजरमेंट से लेकर हाई प्रेशर मेजरमेंट, हमने बहुत सारी वैक्यूम मेजरमेंट स्कीम्स के बारे में डिस्कस किया और एट द एंड हमने हाई प्रेशर मेजरमेंट स्कीम के बारे में भी क्या किया, डिस्कस किया, इट इज कॉल्ड एज ब्रिजमैन गेज। यहाँ पे मैं एक और चीज आपको याद दिलाना चाहूंगा, ब्रिजमैन गेज के साथ साथ आपको एक और नाम याद रखना है जिसे कहते हैं डेड वेट टेस्टर। डेड वेट टेस्टर, डेड वेट टेस्टर इज आल्सो यूज्ड फॉर कैलिब्रेटिंग वेरियस प्रेशर इंस्ट्रूमेंट्स। डेड वेट टेस्टर, ये भी एक इंपॉर्टेंट क्वेश्चन है जो कि एग्जामिनेशन में, पीएसयू एग्जामिनेशन में पूछा जाता है। नॉर्मली पीएसयू एग्जामिनेशन में इन गेजेस के नाम पूछे जा सकते हैं, इन गेजेस की रेंजेस पूछी जा सकती है और इन गेजेस के प्रिंसिपल पूछे जा सकते हैं। तो जो मैंने आपको तीनों चीजें क्या है एक्सप्लेन किए, तो गाइस आप इस लेक्चर को बाद में भी सुन लें एक बार और इन गेजेस के बारे में अपना जो नॉलेज है उसको थोड़ा सा कंफर्म कर लें। ठीक है, थैंक यू वेरी मच गाइस फॉर अटेंडिंग द सेशन पेशनेटली। आपने बहुत सारे यूट्यूब चैनल ज्वाइन किए हैं, आप इस यूट्यूब चैनल को भी ज्वाइन कीजिए, इस चैनल को एक्सप्लोर कीजिए, चैनल को स्प्रेड कीजिए आपके फ्रेंड्स में। क्रिएटिक्स गेट चैनल जिसका नाम है अनअकैडमी गेट MEPI XE, अनअकैडमी गेट सिविल इंजीनियरिंग, अनअकैडमी गेट तेलुगु, अनअकैडमी SSC JEE, अनअकैडमी कंप्यूटर साइंस, अनअकैडमी गेट क्वेश्चंस, इलेक्ट्रिकल जंक्शन, अनअकैडमी इंजीनियरिंग फाउंडेशन, इंजीनियरिंग पाठशाला, बहुत सारे यूट्यूब चैनल से गाइज अनअकैडमी आपको फ्री में ये फैसिलिटी दे रहा है, तो आपको इस फैसिलिटी का पूरा पूरा बेनिफिट क्या करना चाहिए, उठाना चाहिए। तो थैंक यू वेरी मच गाइज फॉर अटेंडिंग माई सेशन पैशनेटली, थैंक यू वेरी मच। Do share, do like and do subscribe and hit the bell icon for all the notifications. Good night. We will see you tomorrow. Thank you very much.